What's up, guys? Welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman. So today I want to show you how to import your own objects into iClone 7. If you like making your own animations, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. For this video, we're gonna aim for 52 likes. Hit the like button and let's continue. Here is the 3D hallway. It's already been texturized. I flipped the normals. You can't see it here, but once we bring this into iClone 7, you're going to see that the normals have been reversed. Okay, so let's export this to iClone. I'm going to export this as an FBX. I'm going to call it a Le Super Room, just because we can. And let's bring it into iClone 7 3D Xchange. This is a plugin for iClone 7. I'm simply going to hit OK, leave that there as it is. Here is the 3D hallway. You can see that the normals have been flipped. If you go inside the box, you can see that it's not transparent. It's only transparent from outside. Okay, so let me load the texture for this. I'm going to open the diffuse color. This is the texture we made in the previous video. Here it is. And this is all ready for iClone 7. Okay, so let's export this for iClone 7. I'm just simply going to call it a Le Super Room, just because we can. Let's import the object. Here it is. There is the hallway. And so let's bring in a character. Let's bring in, let's say, this guy here. Takes a while to load. Here it is. Whoa, he's a little too big. Let me just rotate him. I'm going to rotate him 90 degrees. There you go. But the room is kind of small, so let me just make this bigger. There it is. Let's move this to the right. Change the workspace. Let's go to animation. And let's see, let me just delete these lights here in the sky. We don't actually need that for this. I'm gonna go to the motion puppet. And let's see, I'm gonna go to move. And let's apply some basic walking. I'm gonna exaggerate this a little bit. Press preview. That looks fine. I'm going to record about, let's say, maybe 500 frames. There we go. That's another thing. Let me close this here. Press G for top view. And I'm going to move him somewhere around here. Let's play it. See what it looks like. First try, not too bad. Let me see what that looks like again. I'm gonna duplicate the room maybe 3 times. I'm going to take the last piece and I'm going to place this in the middle. Let's play this again. That looks good. I'm going to create a new camera. Let me adjust the angle here. I'm gonna go to frame 500. Or whenever he stops, which is around here, and let's simply zoom in. I'm gonna find the final position for this. Somewhere around there. That looks not too bad there. All right, let me just play this back. Not too bad. And let's apply the ambience, turn off the shadow, and there is our final result. Alright, so if you're not subscribed to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Alright guys, see you in the next video. Bye now.